I'm Christine Dobbin with this breaking news update. We have just learned this exclusive information from our sources at Rice University that the Griffins will be leaving Hanszen College. This is very disturbing news. We are told that the students are so upset, they're having troubles focusing on their studies because they've learned that Rob, Ann, Liam, and Mary will all be leaving Hanszen at the end of this school year. Now, what is that? I'm getting information from our producer that there is a riot breaking out. We're being dispatched to Rice University. There's a riot breaking out as a result of this news. We're going to have to move to that scene. We'll bring you the latest once we get there. Hi, Rob and Ann.
Hi, Rob and Ann.
Rob and Ann.
Hey, Rob and Ann.
Hey, Rob and Ann.
Hey, Rob and Ann. I just wanted to say thanks for everything you've done for us this year.
I'll just tell you, you're awesome. Thank you for being such amazing masters. And thank you for all the advice you gave us when we graduated.
And I love spending Monday nights watching Amazing Race with you and your family.
I cannot believe that it has been 5 years since you took over as Hanszen Masters.
So I really always admired the job that Rob and Ann did of walking this several incredibly hard lines. You know, trying to raise a family while also trying to be masters to these 300 students who really had no idea what they were doing half the time.
What I love about Rob and Ann is that they gave it to you straight. I think that a lot of times as a college student, you know, you get bullshitted a lot. People tell you things that sound good because it will make you feel good.
Whenever I would see you guys, A, you would always have a huge smile on your face regardless of what was going on, which is awesome. Second of all, whether you actually cared or not, you always seemed like you really cared about what was going on in my day. Like, I would always, you ask everybody, you're like, hey, how's it going? But it's not like the superficial kind that some people have.
Yeah.
Like, I really thought that you guys cared. I don't know if you did. But.
I think what I'm gonna always miss about Rob and Ann is how they were sort of always there for you. Like, even when their door was closed, you could always just sort of knock on it or call them until they finally complied and opened the door.
So I guess my first memories of Rob and Ann were just about how welcoming they were when I first got here. Because as most people know, I was a transfer student and I lived off campus my first year here. And I was very scared of not being able to get integrated, but Rob and Ann would hold the study break. I would just show up to their study breaks all the time and they were so welcoming to me. I really cherish that. I don't know if I could have gotten as integrated without Robin Ann being so welcoming.
I just remember all the Monday nights when we go over for ice cream and how you guys genuinely ask each and every one of us how we're doing and if there's anything that you guys could do to help. And every time I just felt so loved and so cared for. And you guys were truly a part of the Hanszen experience.
So even though the masters are really busy with, you know, being masters and being a professor and working, everything, they never forgot about us as individuals. I remember one time I was going through a really hard time. Our whole suite was really, and I ended up going to ice cream kind of late, and I just sat and talked with Ann for like half an hour, and it was really incredible how much she really cared about what I was going through at the time, and wanting to make sure that I was all right, and just giving me hugs and support.
They're always a good time, and I've just felt very comfortable with them anytime I talk to them. And they've also been extremely supportive. I know Rob has come to a bunch of my plays, and it's just nice to know that I've had that support here at Hanszen.
I remember the fall of my freshman year, I ended up having to go to the emergency room after I dislocated my knee, and you know, within a few hours, Rob and Ann had reached out and asked me if everything was okay. And you know, at that point, I kind of knew that, you know, they were there for me. You know, anything that I needed, I could go and talk to them, and you know, they'd be there.
Rob and Ann are like a second set of parents to me. I know that is something that is very well known, in addition to being some really great friends. In fact, my current boyfriend, when I was talking to him about having to impress my parents, I told him, you also have to impress Rob and Ann.
So thoughtful, they're so caring, and I really appreciated all their help this year with social stuff, personal stuff. Just this year has been really, really rough for Hanszen.
Freshman year, this was around the time of like when advisor applications were about to go out, and I was really thinking about advising, and I really wanted to be involved with OE. And so I was talking to Rob at a lunch table, and I was like, you know, I don't really even know if it's worth it, because I'm not like super involved with Hanszen, and I don't know if I would be a really good candidate. And Rob was like, no, you should still apply, just like apply. You never know. You never know. You might as well just do it. And like 2 weeks later, I found out that I had been selected to be an advisor. And out of the blue, he like comes up to me while I'm in the server, and he just like, you know, pokes me, and he's like, "Hey, you did it. I told you, you're gonna be great." And that was like the most reaffirming statement that I've ever heard. And when I talked to Anne later, she was like, "We are really excited to have you on the team, and it's gonna be a really great week." And that was just, I felt like I truly belonged at that moment. I was like, Hanszen is this community that I'm a part of. And Rob and Anne have been such an integral part in making me feel that way about Hanszen.
It's been an amazing experience having you guys here. I know Hanszen is gonna dearly, dearly miss y'all. It's just been a spectacular few years with you guys as masters.
Of course, your ice cream nights are delicious, and your general aura as a couple, as a family, is a really great dynamic to bring to Hanszen. We are a family college, and I feel as though I'm really happy around you two.
Rob and Anne provide an amazing support network for every student here at Hanszen. They really are the backbone of our Hanszen College community.
We've had our ups and downs. We've laughed together, we've cried together. We've been through so much already, and you guys, through it all, have always, always supported me and everything. And I know I'm not the best at saying thank you, but I do thank you. And even maybe the times I didn't say thank you, I just want you to know that I've always, always been extremely grateful for everything that you guys have done, not just for me, but for Hanszen, for the students.
It's been really great to see them support students just all the time, whether that's seeing them at athletic events like basketball games. They'll bring Liam and Mary and, you know, cheer everyone on, or at like Powder Puff games or just other like student events. The entire family has been, you know, really supportive and always a lot of fun.
You have both done a tremendous job and given so much to Rice, to Hanszen, and to us students. While I'm sure it's been a long and difficult journey, I hope you realize the impact you've had on so many of us.
I also love that before every cabinet, they knew that I loved craft beer. You know, they knew that I loved it, and they knew how nervous I would get before speaking in front of people. And so I would practice cabinet for like an hour before cabinet. I mean, which is embarrassing to admit, but I would practice it because I got so nervous, and they knew that. So in addition to other things I was stressed out about, I would come over to their house before cabinet. I know that they still do this with the other presidents, and they would give me a beer, and we would just talk about life. And it was a time that I didn't get with anyone else, and they were 140% devoted to finding out about cocoa. And that's, I can't imagine their focus and patience, because they do that with everyone. You know, I mean, when you have focused time with them, they are genuinely interested in what you're doing and what's going on, and they ask you intelligent questions, and they're thinking through what you're saying, and they're not just going through the rungs. They have genuine conversation with you. And I had that for every cabinet, and it gave me the confidence, it gave me my wings, it gave me what I needed to do what I needed. I love you, Rob and Anne.
We were talking about MacGuffin with them quite a bit. And at one point we did mention to Rob, you know, "Oh yeah, you know, it's your last MacGuffin, like, you know, maybe you should think about doing it." And then at a certain point he's like, yeah, sure, let's do it. And we were like, okay, yeah, that'll never happen. But he followed through and got Dennis and the rest of the RAs as well to do it with him. And while I didn't get to go around and watch too much of it, I saw some of the video and it was hilarious. So it was really neat to see him, and supporting him, throughout the whole MacGuffin, making a fool of himself, but doing it, you know, just to have that one last kind of classic Hanszen OB experience.
And Rob, much as I like you, my overriding experience of you will be with MacGuffin. With the suck and blow contest of the playing card, I got way too close to you, and I really didn't need to know that you didn't shave at 5 o'clock in the morning. But anyway, that'll be my endearing long-term experience of getting to know you.
A couple years ago for Beer Bike, I'm sure Rob remembers, he had this pretty mohawk that was blue and like gold, yellow, and it was incredible. And
I've heard stories of how some other professors were like, dude, I have a mohawk. But I think that was cool for me because it was like, Hanson's fear, like even your master has a mohawk.
And you know, Rob, I just want to say thank you for like all the help that you've given me with, you know, the civy stuff and like trying to find my way through this crazy department. And you know, I have been planning my schedule around you because you are leaving. So I hope you know that.
Throughout my 4 years, I've gotten to know Rob particularly well. My freshman year, I worked in his lab for 2 years. I was an OE coordinator, a member of Hanszen College, of course, and then as a college president, I got to work with him as well. And so, and I also got to see him as a professor. And throughout all those processes, Rob was always sort of the campus favorite for being able to put students first. As a professor, he didn't give out assignments during Willy Week because he knew we wouldn't get anything done, or whenever we had big exams coming up in our other miserable civil engineering classes, he'd give us a week off.
Although sometimes Rob's sarcasm is a little too much for me. I'm not very good with sarcasm.
I think my favorite memory of Rob was that time he was really sassy to me, which was every single conversation that I've had with Rob.
Getting picked on while everyone else stares flabbergasted at the sarcasm that's coming from you towards me.
All of your sass, although you insist that's for love, but I can never really understand that.
He's definitely the sassiest boy on campus.
Love you anyways, Rob, despite all of your sass. And thank you so much for being absolutely amazing.
There was a senior dinner where Baker 13 was coming up and I was kind of on the fence about doing it, and my roommates were all trying to convince me to do it and I wasn't really sure. And so then the next morning, Anne sends me an email saying that she was at the grocery store and she found some orange shaving cream. So she just bought it right there on the spot and told me to come pick it up so that I could go do Baker 13. And that kind of pushed me over the edge and convinced me to do Baker 13. So, I mean, I'm glad that I've always had Rob and Anne here just to kind of, you know, push me along the way and kind of be a supporting factor in my time in Hanson.
We need a shout out to Anne being one of the awesomest Powderpuff players ever.
True that.
Definitely the best Powderpuff master player ever.
And the first thing I learned was that Anne plays Powderpuff. And I was like, oh, it's Powderpuff. Like, that sounds so cool. And so I came out and she was so good. And I was like her backup on tight end. And so she was showing me the ropes. And I just thought it was so cool that like our master played and we were so good and we beat everyone else. And
Powderpuff with Anne is probably one of the coolest parts of my Hanson experience. I mean, playing Powderpuff in general was great, but the fact that Hanson has, I think, probably the only masters while I've been at Rice that would play IM sports with the students is really cool. She was just a great contribution to the team, always brought humor to the P-Puff field as well as like hardcore intensity. So I really loved playing Powderpuff with her.
She was always about the team aspect and making sure that all the girls felt included, we all felt important, and that we were all motivated to be a part of the team. And so she was always cheering us on and always being a great sport. She definitely brought that competitive edge that we needed sometimes to get our stuff together and to play really well.
So I think my favorite memory of Anne was once the Hanson team was playing Powderpuff and I was watching the game, and one of my friends from another college was there with me, and he asked, oh, like, is that your master playing? I was like, yeah. And he was like, oh, like, that's cool that she plays, I guess. And I was like, no, like, she's one of our best players too. And then he was not very convinced. He was like, okay, like, whatever, like, master playing, whatever. And then that very next play, like, Audrey throws a perfect pass, like, right to Anne. She catches it and takes it for the first down. And I didn't even have to say anything. I just turned to him and made a funny face. And he was like, okay, I stand corrected.
I've gotten to build our relationship through, you know, Anne getting to play with you on the Powderpuff field or on the basketball court where we won 3 women's basketball championships.
Playing basketball with Anne these past 3 years for me have been really awesome. Getting to see her like in her zone. Literally, she was so great at basketball and we could always count on her to be there and put in 100% even when she was injured. I think winning those championships every year was just like the most amazing thing. And even when we lost to DSA and IM basketball, it was still incredible because we were as a team.
Hi, Lima, Mary, sorry. We don't mean to leave you out.
Yeah. So I also want to say thanks, Mary, for practicing Powderpuff with me.
And for Liam attempting to teach me about basketball, I still don't think I actually know any of the positions, but thank you for trying.
I remember Rob and Liam and Mary would be sitting there like cheering us on, so excited, and when I hurt myself and was out for like one of the multiple games I was out, I would throw the football with Liam and Mary, and we had so much fun, and I just thought it was so cool that like from the beginning they were so involved, not in just supporting students, but like being on the field with us and like really spending time with us.
I've also really enjoyed getting to know Liam and Mary and watching them grow up. And I hope to continue to be part of their lives as we move forward.
I was selected to be a coordinator, and then suddenly Liam and Mary just like noticed me, but they didn't know my name or they didn't want to use it, so they always just called me Mr. Coordinator, which was cute and also confusing at the same time. Sort of like I hear, "Hi, Mr. Coordinator," and I have to be like, "Wait, that's me. Oh, hey, Liam, hey, Mary." And like, now they found out that my name that I used to be called back at home was Eddie, so now all the time when they see me, they're like, "Hey, Eddie," and they like say it all the time, grinds my ears, but you know, let's just Liam and Mary. I love them so much anyway, so.
One of my favorite things about Liam and Mary is the way they would greet me anytime I saw them in the street. So anytime Liam sees me, he screams really loudly at the top of his lungs, "Shuby!" And it's always adorable. The other thing that happens anytime I see Mary, she has an intense stare off with me, making the like meanest, scariest face, usually something along the lines of like that. But it's like 30 million times cuter because it's Mary.
One of the things I really love is Lucy, which I know is not directly Robin Ann, but you know, it's having a dog pack at home is fun, and then like, but it's like really rough leaving, so like Lucy has been a great resource for me.
I remember getting here at O-Week and actually being more excited about meeting their dog than I was about meeting them, but over time it became very clear that they were going to be a great resource for me and someone to go to over my time at Rice, and I really couldn't be more thankful for all the meaningful conversations I've had with them and everything they've done for me over the last 2 years.
Their genuine interest and concern in students what really makes them amazing masters. And for me personally, they've always been there, whether it's been midday or 2 a.m., they've always been just a phone call away. And for that, I cannot thank them enough. So thank you, Robin Ann.
I think, you know, in both of you, I found obviously great masters, great mentors, but just really great friends who you could always go to and talk to whenever you had a problem.
They've just been such a great support in every single way I could possibly imagine.
I thank them for giving me doses of reality in my college experience when otherwise I just wouldn't have had it. So they're really wonderful people because they made me, it sounds so damn cheesy, but they made me want to be a better, more thoughtful person as they are.
And realized more and more that they weren't doing it because they thought it was just so fun and so wonderful and they missed college and things like that. But just the way that they were doing it for us. And because of that, they had this really, really strong insistence on letting students run the college, which is more than a lot of masters I've heard of. And I've heard lots of stories from other people about the way that masters do things. It was horrifying me, and I couldn't imagine it. Because Rob and Anne were always so intentional about taking a step back and letting us make choices.
One thing I really appreciate about Rob was just being able to talk openly with him about things that were going on in my own life. And last semester during finals, I was having a rough time with some things back home, and it was stressful, especially during finals, but I talked with Rob, and even after break this semester, he followed up with me, and it meant a lot to me that he remembered what was going on and cared to ask me about it.
It's been absolutely amazing getting to know you guys. You've been playing such a significant role since I came here to Rice. It wasn't easy at first, like any other college student, especially being so far away from home, but you've just felt like another mother and father to me.
When I didn't know where else to turn, didn't know what else I could do, Rob and Ann just come over to our house, talk to us, and we'll direct you in the right direction, we'll be there for you. And I cherish that so much. When I was facing taking time off from school, literally one of the things holding me back, I knew I had to go, I knew I needed some time off. So I was like, man, if I leave, when I graduate, Rob and Ann will be my masters.
But you guys have really cared so much for me and everyone else here, and it's evident that you guys really did raise such a great culture of care here.
I just want to say thank you all so much for being such an amazing support system, especially when I needed you both.
I am just so thankful that you guys have been a part of my college experience, and I really could not have asked for better masters. You're just like a great source of support.
You have shaped my time at Rice. There's no other way to say it. Whether it was on a fluids problem set, the midnight breakfast study break, or convincing me to get on the plane to go to San Francisco, I will never forget you being at Hanszen with us.
Love you guys. I don't know what to say. Just thank you. There are really no words to express how I feel about all the years that we did together, that we were here at Hanszen. You are an inspiring couple in so many ways, so many levels. I'm just speechless. I love you. Love Leo and Mary too. Was so happy to be here those 5 years with you. And I just hope that we never stop seeing each other. And you have an invitation to go to Chile anytime.
You truly made Hanszen the best college. And we thank you guys so much for choosing to spend some of your lives with us.
Given how close we got and how much I just enjoyed spending time with both of you and Leo and Mary, obviously, it's really going to be tough to see you guys leaving Hanszen. For me, Hanszen is you guys, just as much as it is everybody else.
We recognize that there's a lot of stuff behind the scenes that they have to do, a lot of decisions that sometimes we may not agree with, but they really did have our best interests at heart, and it's a very difficult job to do. And Rob and Anne were very selfless over the last 5 years in giving their life and letting their family live on campus and get to experience students both in their best and worst of times and helping them through both of those. I'm very grateful that I've had Rob and Anne here. They were like a second set of parents to me during my time, and although they'll still be around Hanszen, I know that the Braces have very big shoes to fill, and I'm confident that they can do so, but I do think that after 5 years, Hanszen is a bit better of a place because of Rob and Anne.
Thank you both for everything that you've done for Hanszen, for being a great set of masters, great friends, and a second set of parents to me. I've really appreciated it, and I couldn't have asked for a better family to have spent in my place.
I haven't really gone to Rob and Anne for help that much, but the times that I have, they've always been really comforting, and they've always known what to do and take care of things. So I think having that sort of, projecting that sort of confidence and that sort of authority really makes me feel like I have this safety net for me throughout my entire college experience. And I think just having that there definitely changes what I do and how confident I am and the kinds of things that I pursue, just knowing that I have this support always there for me.
Rob and Anne, you've been such an integral part of the support network at Hanszen that it's hard to imagine what it would be like after.
Well, Rob and Anne, thank you so much for all of the time and effort that you put in into Hanszen. I'll never forget all of the times that we shared, and I hope that you stay in touch and that you have a great life after Hanszen, and know that we'll always be here for you.
Thank you so much for always being there for us, being so supportive and kind. And it really made my first year at Hanszen something really special.
Thank you so much for all you've done. You really are been a blessing.
And Anne, thank you so much for laughing at my jokes. I know they're awful, and I know that you're only humoring me, but it's encouraged me to try and come up with better jokes.
Yeah, thanks. Yeah. we've enjoyed spending our first year with you, and we're going to miss you, and we're going to miss Mary and Liam, and you made us feel so welcome coming in for our first year, and it's been an exciting year. It's been amazing, and we appreciate everything you've done for us, and we're going to miss you.
I'm sad to see them go, but I'm really excited for what's in store for them in the future, and I wish them all the best, and I hope that they'll be around Hanszen often, and hopefully Liam and Mary as well.
I'm going to miss you guys a lot, but you guys are going to have a year off, and y'all deserve that. Y'all worked really hard, and if no one else says it, I just want you to know that I've always appreciated everything you've done, and I wish you all the best.
To the both of you, thank you so much. Love you guys so much, and wish you nothing but the best.
Hey Rob and Anne, we want to thank you for the service that you've done to Hanszen. Danny and I are honored to have worked with you this year. very much. I'm sure that the rest of Hanszen will miss you as well, but we also wish you the best in what is yet to come. Thank you.
Thank you.
Rob and Anne, this is a dual thank you and apology for knowing me, you know? Okay. I love you guys so much.
Rob, Anne, Liam, Mary, all my best wishes for all of you as you begin the next chapter at Rice, and know that you will be very, very missed by alumni and current students of Hanszen alike. So enjoy the celebratory period and all the best to you guys in your next step.
Hey, Rob and Anne and Liam and Mary, I just wanted to thank y'all so much for everything you've done for Hanszen over the past 5 years. And thanks for welcoming hundreds of Hansenites into your hearts and into your home and into your family. I know that Hanszen's gonna miss you, and I just want to wish you the best of luck on your next great adventure.
We love you, Rob and Anne.
Good luck!
Thank you guys so much for all that you've done over the past 5 years as masters. It has been wonderful to be able to be at Rice and be in Hanszen. When you guys have been masters, I'm so excited to have gotten to know you and can't wait to see you again.
Thank you for always being there. You have helped me through some of my most difficult times. You've guided me to great successes, and you've helped me make really difficult decisions. I am very excited for your next phase after your time at Hanszen. You both deserve it, and you will have a wonderful time as a family. I can't wait to continue our relationship beyond the Hanszen Master House. Congratulations on being wonderful masters. Thank you so much, and I'm so excited to celebrate this moment.
Thank you so much. I'm gonna miss you so much.
But anyway, we love you guys.
Yeah.